But in Islam, we believe iman is thicker than blood. We have. So me, when Qadet, rahimahullah, when he passed away, he is like my own brother. Now I'm not gonna come and lie and sugarcoat and make it seem like I would be as upset as his mother and his own blood brother. I'm not gonna lie, I'm not gonna make out to be something it's not. I was hurt, I was upset. But the pain they feel, obviously I can't. So that's the reason I did it.
Money.
Okay, and now I want to talk about social prostitutes, yeah? I'm going to be very straight and to the point, yeah? Social prostitutes, who am I talking about? They know who they are, yeah?
Money.
Very simple, fam. I'll decide where it's going to go. Hold your mouth. No apology. I'm not apologizing for nothing. I'm not here to apologize. But
money.
When I dress you, come back, we'll talk. Okay.
So,
you're a fool. You're a clown. You're a clown. You're a clown. You're a clown. That's what you are. Yeah?
Stick to it.
So, I don't care, bro. I don't care. He's a monastic. Five star grade, a monastic.
I want to be a bystander.
Five star grade,
he's not slandering.
Brother, don't talk.
I say what I want.
So, I'm making it very clear, yeah? These accusations that's been thrown at us, yeah? That we put, right, listen. We put money in our pocket, yeah? I'm making it very simple. Here's a simple challenge. Here's a simple challenge.
Until Kalam is here, until
Kalam is here, I'm anybody that Kalam. Proves
so what?
That we put £1
why not?
Of
why not?
Charity,
why not?
£1 Kalam is a five-star grade
so
at Munafiq.
So does he. So does he, fam. This is how man makes his living. Don't get what he's
anybody,
doing.
If anybody proves that we put £1 of that charity money in my pocket, I swear to God, I'm going to shut my YouTube channel, Instagram, Snapchat, wallahi. I'm going to do public repentance and I'm going to back off.
Money.
Deceived you, my friend, but
if you show me the cash, then I will take it. If you tell me to cry, then I will fake it. If you give me your hand, then I will shake it.
You do anything for money.
Anything, anything, yeah. Anything for money. Die for you, die for you. I sell my soul to the devil.
Anything.
Hello, people. This is Shogat-san. I saw a video on Titans TV a few days ago about Ali Dawa and how he used the death of some random individual to raise money for some cause he's got in Africa. Okay, I said, just let it go, okay, because there's no philosophical importance here. He's just a crook. But then this guy insisted. Why? You want to come on top, even in this thing. You think you are so clever, eh? That you can even bullshit your way out of this. No. First of all, who is Ali Dawa and Mohammed Hijab, his friend?
We need 2 tickets to Los Angeles, as soon as possible.
Los Angeles, okay. I have a 2 o'clock flight. That would be $400 each.
Sir, you don't understand. We have to see Magic Johnson right away. You see, we have AIDS.
AIDS? Wow, that's really retro. But I'm sorry, I can't just give away free seats.
Don't you get it? We are 2 pals, afflicted with an illness, and who only have each other in a race against time. Innocent, playful children who are stricken with a deadly disease for no reason.
Those are 2 individuals that have hundreds of thousands of subscribers. They beg for money, and they use this money to promote an evil cult, to promote political Islam. In other words, people give those people money to buy, I don't know, plane tickets, food, new coats, okay? To have a luxury life, in other words. at the same time making the world a shittier place.
We're so happy to help accommodate you brave boys. What kind of cancer did you say you have again?
Oh, you know, all over cancer.
I'm so sorry.
Yeah, well, at least it's not as bad as having AIDS. AIDS is the worst disease.
I don't know. These days I think I'd rather have AIDS than cancer.
No, you would. Look, shouldn't you be serving people drinks or something? Get out of here! We're on our way, buddy. Magic Johnson, here we come.
This is what these guys are doing. So, Maria gives £20 to Ali Dawa, so he can say that pedophilia is okay. John gives £30 to Mohammed Hijab, so he can say democracy is not okay. You know, this kind of thing.
Magic, could you come to the front for a minute? There are a couple of boys here to see you. Two brave little buddies who, against all odds, have journeyed across America to find the cure for AIDS. All they have is each other and a race against time.
Then those two went to Africa and start preaching hate. Okay? They went to Africa to preach hate and to promote Islam. They did nothing else there. They went there, they preached hate against Christianity and UK and promoted Islam.
You see, about 100 years ago, the British Empire came to this country with their missionaries, and they told the people that Jesus should be believed in as God. I want to tell everyone today that that was the wrong thing for them to say. This is what you must know, that when the colonizer came over to the Golden Coast 100 years ago, yes, they tried to take your minerals. They tried to take your gold. And they tried to tell you now to be Christian. Do you know what's happening in my country now? I live in the UK. Yes. They are becoming atheists. Did you know that? They are becoming atheists, ladies and gentlemen. The same people that came to you. The same people that came to you 100 years ago. The English, the British, the colonizer. The imperial power that came to the Gold Coast. Those guys are now leaving Christianity. They told you to believe in something that now their grandchildren are leaving.
Mohammed, you're a bit confused. The Western colonization was for economy and power. The Muslim conquest was for religion. The sweet voice you heard at the end was my voice. The voice of reason. Okay, but you get the picture, okay? They went to Africa for the mere reason to spread Islam, okay? These people have no other agenda other than spread Islam and doing it comfortably. That is the only agenda and their only goal. Nothing else. They want to have fun in this world and, of course, fuck virgins in the afterlife.
Now, we need the following. 2 billion Muslims exist on this planet. We are looking for just 500 selected people that will give just £100. And this will help us to convey the message clearly around the world. If we don't ask you for help, brothers and sisters, who are we going to turn to? Allah says in the Quran,
من ذا الذي يقرض الله قرضا حسنا فيضاعفه له أضعافا كثيرة.
Nice song. I will send you some money. Yes, people, don't send your money to African kids, for example, okay? Send your money to two morons in Britain to mine masturbate. Yes, the voice you heard at the end, it was me again. Thank you. But let's go back to the issue at hand. Because, okay, we know Mohammed Hijab and Ali Dawa saved Africa, but this is in the past. Let's come to now.
You know what you are saying, I'm like it. God is good. God is good. God is good. You know, I try my very best not to actually hold back and just talk straight from my heart, okay? And I'm telling you, this is what I'm feeling, okay? This is what I'm feeling. For me, I'm now witnessing somebody make a mockery out of somebody's death. That is what I am witnessing. I'm witnessing a lot of insincerity, okay? I'm witnessing a person who did not know the individual, was not friends with the individual, but calling themselves friends and calling others to be friends with that person. I'm witnessing a person, right, who did not even come down. He's a regular at Speaker's Corner, right? Did not even come down to the tribute or the memorial, whichever name you want to call it, right? On the Sunday. Right? I did not see the brother at all. I did not see it at all. But all of a sudden, you're a friend. All of a sudden, you're a friend. All of a sudden, now you want to save somebody. You can't save yourself, yet you want to save others. Do you know how much that pained my heart to see that? I don't think you understand. I don't think you guys understand. Just imagine, okay? Just imagine, somebody you personally know. And then somebody who else doesn't personally know that individual comes out to make a ridiculous video like that. A lot of us in the ends are mourning. A lot of us in the ends are grieving. A lot of us in the ends don't even know how to take this. I'm speaking to people who are so close to my brother and they're literally in tears. They're breaking up. And we're talking about big men. And then we have somebody like Ali Dow, an opportunist, coming on to talk about pardon me, I'm not mentioning no names. Okay, this is not befitting of his name, right? It's not befitting of that.
So let's make a summary what this fool did. Okay. He made a video, saved a person who already died, okay, by donating to this account. And his justification was a moronic verse in the Quran that says, even if somebody has passed away, okay, you can still donate in his name and that will help him go to paradise. Ali Dawa assumes that this poor kid is now in hell. Why, you might ask? Because he was making music, and music is haram. So people now need to donate to Ali Dawa to save this poor kid. Yeah?
But let's just quickly read it. It says here, Abu Huraira, all right? For some of people, Abu Hanifa didn't really take kindly to him. But nonetheless, let's just discuss it real quickly. When a man dies, his acts come to an end. All right, we don't have no problem with that. But three things remain or you kind of intimating that these acts still continue and you still merit reward from it. Okay, says here, sadaqa jariya, which is reoccurring charity. Okay, or when somebody, gives knowledge to another individual, to the people that benefits. Okay, that's another thing. Okay, all right. And the third one is when a pious son. So, if you have a pious son, you've given birth to a pious son, and now that pious son now makes dua for you. Okay, it makes dua for you. So right here, a pious son makes, or a pious son there makes a dua for you, okay? So these are the three things where you're still being rewarded for. Three things, okay? Three things. If you've done something, i.e. set up a charity, okay? You've set up a charity. It's still, and even though you pass on, it will still draw benefits to you, all right? And that there is called sadaqa jariya, for those of people who don't know, all right? And another one, all right, is when you give ilm, when you give knowledge, you pass on knowledge to others, right? You pass on knowledge that is beneficial. That will still continue. What does that mean? It means that if I say something to you today that you didn't know, right, it can benefit you now and it can benefit other people because you'll pass on that knowledge. But that's one piece of knowledge stemmed from... If you're Muslim, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has now given it to you, right? And you've now transpired or transmitted onto other people. So there's three ways, all right? And sadaqa jariya. Sadaqa is obviously charity. Jariya is to like go forth. Like even you, sometimes you call servants or young girls jariya. Like something that continues basically, goes out, right? These are three forms. Three forms. Now, I want to know, how does a person receive sadaqa jariya? How does a person... be rewarded for something, right? They themselves did not do.
Very nice point. Ali Dawa, you did a mistake, my friend. Your effort was useless because you didn't understand this hadith. Okay, you didn't understand not even this hadith. Okay, okay, you are a useless person. Okay, you cannot understand anything, anything. So your whole conundrum here was useless, was useless. Okay, so in other words, you asked for money to your account in order to save a person you didn't even know, and without asking the permission of his family, the person you want to save have already passed away. You insult his memory by implying that this person is in hell because he didn't follow exactly the rules of your moronic death cult. And your whole justification for doing that, theologically, was wrong. Is that what happened? Ali Dawa, is that what happened? I mean, oh, there is no bottom in your stupidity, my friend. And talking about stupidity, look what this guy said the same day in another debate.
Black is happy day.
My brother.
Your church is raping.
Give me my question. What does it mean? This man said that Yom Tifun means bleeding. Now, it means bleeding.
Bleeding, yeah.
Right? And your Quran says that after those little boys serve you wine in Jannah, they won't bleed. He has confirmed it.
So, huge accusation here, okay? I don't know if that's true. I don't know. Okay, I'm ignorant about this. But the accusation is huge, okay? This guy said that your God in Jannah sodomizes boys. That was the claim. And look how Ali Dawa tries to defend against this argument.
I asked this is the following, yeah? Because Deal with the question, Ali Dawa. Ali, don't be scared. They're not ready for this. Yeah? They're not ready for what I'm about to say. They're asking, why does boys bleed in paradise? Fam, I don't know about boys bleeding in paradise, but little boys are getting raped and bleeding in the church.
Oh, yes.
Bravo, congratulations. You dealt with this argument very nicely. But why some priests also molest children in the church? Okay, let's continue.
Answer, brother!
You are comparing. You are comparing Allah and human.
Wowzers. Okay, so you guys are on your laurels, you know? You got the ability to intercede for somebody. You got the ability to save somebody. Hmm? All right, cool. I'm still waiting for that explanation of how, though. Yeah, I really want to see the explanation of how. So if you cannot save yourself, let alone save somebody who's passed away, how and why are you raising money to save somebody who's passed away? I had a dream I could buy my way into heaven. Wow. Wow, let me know. Now, please correct me if I'm wrong. When you say save someone, if I say save me, yeah? Don't forget anybody else. But if I personally said save me, what does that mean? That means I'm in personal danger. That means there is something where I am not whole. I am not right. There is something wrong. There is something aggravating me where I need somebody else outside of my own self to come in and help me and save me and pull me up and out of the danger that I'm in. Now let me know if that is not insensitive. Let me know if that is not insensitive. Already in your mind's eye. Already in your mind's eye, you're picturing somebody who is loved near and dear to hundreds, if not thousands, of people. You're already imagining them burning in the hellfire.
And yes, and that was the most serious point in this video. Okay. Ali Dawa thinks that a young man is in special need for salvation. Okay. Imagine the psychotic insanity of Ali Dawa that thinks that just because a person made melodies with his mouth is a candidate to go to hell. Okay. Just read the descriptions of hell in the Quran. Okay. And Ali Dawa has such an insanity that thinks just because a person made melody with his mouth is deserving this fate and he needs to save him. Now, my question to Muslim, do you think these insane people are the good exemplars for the Muslim community? Eh?
Because you can't be saying, save them from the paradise. You can't be saying, save them from what? From heaven. You can't be doing that. What exactly are you saying?
Kalam, let me explain how their mind works. Okay. First of all, Ali Dawa is a good person. He's just an idiot. He doesn't understand the implications of what he's saying. Let me make a very serious point here. No one can bear see a fellow human being burned and take it for too long. Okay, it's impossible. It's against human nature. When I say no one, not even the Green River serial killer, not even Hitler, not even Jack the Ripper, no one. No one can see a fellow human being burned. So, whoever is truly conscious of what God is doing to people, by definition, he denounces that God. Let me repeat that. Therefore, whoever is truly conscious of what God is doing in hell, by definition, he denounces that God. Let's take the more extreme Muslim fanatic, okay? Osama bin Laden. I take Osama bin Laden and I put him in a chair near hell. And he watches a person being burned for 5 minutes, 6 minutes, 7 minutes, 8 minutes, 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours. At the fourth hour, he will say, stop it, God, I hate you, okay? Even bin Laden. It's impossible for a human to see these things. It's torture. Therefore, what that means, that whoever is fully conscious of what God is doing, he denounces that God by definition. Okay? Try to understand what I just said. So the implication of what I just said is that there are no people that actually believe in hell and still worship the God who sends people to hell. There are no such people, okay? Simply because of human nature. Ali Dawa doesn't really believe in hell. He simply doesn't got deep thought, okay? He just reads and takes things lightly. Ah, what? God is throwing lead to someone's throat, eh? Ah, okay. Okay, that is what's going on with Ali Dawa. He simply hasn't got deep thought. Now, my other question is, why you send your money to idiots? Why? That harm the Muslim community. Why? Is there any reason? I don't know. Anything, anything for my name.